Okay, so we are having a tutorial. In first tutorial, we have seen how to use the Proteus. We installed the Proteus and seen the LCD interfacing in Proteus. Today, what I want to see is that we'll have the temperature sensor LM35 that will be interfaced with Arduino, but that sensor value will be printed on the LCD screen. Instead of being printed on the virtual monitor, it will be printed on the LCD. I will share one video where I have used the LM35 sensor and the values are printed on the serial monitor. In Proteus, it has a virtual serial monitor. So using that, you can print it. But this video I'm making in order to show you how to print those characters, how to print the temperature values got from the LM35 sensor on the LCD screen. Okay, we'll start a fresh project, have a new project. And name of the project will be, here I'm going to give LM35 LCD. This name I'm going to use. Next, 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 and finish. So that is going to generate this schematic capture for us. Now click on the component mode. Click on this P shortcut. Here is Arduino. Let's use simulator Arduino. Click on OK. I also require one LCD, so I am going to type here LCD. The LCD which we are going to use is a 16:2 alphanumeric LCD. This is that one, LM016L. So select it as OK. Now, I also require a temperature sensor, so I will be using LM35. So you will get very first option. Say OK. So let's start designing. Let's bring simulator, you know. Let me maximize this and you can adjust this green rectangle so have the proper view. Then let's have the LCD, so I'm going to put LCD over here. Right, as you know the connections, we have done that earlier, so let me do it fast. So I'm going to connect this RS to pin number 2, then this E to pin number 3, then D4 to pin number 4, D5 to pin number 5, D6 to pin number 6, D7 to pin number 7. I'm not going to explain how these connections are to be done. That theory is already covered, and if you are not able to go get that, please see my earlier videos. Go through my earlier videos. You will find the detailed explanation about this connection. Now I need to ground the RW pin. So I will click on this terminal modes. There is a ground symbol is given. So connect that ground here. And I'm going to connect the RW pin to the ground so that the LCD will be in the right mode. So similarly, VSS is needed to be connected to ground. So why not use the same ground? I'm using the same ground. It's connected. I also require the power to be given to VDD, so as the LCD will have the backlight on. So now these connections for LCD are done. Now go back to the component mode and select the LM35. I need to adjust this rectangle a little bit. Okay, that is enough. So now take LM35, place it on this side. I used this LM35 earlier. So what happened is that taking the 5 volt and ground from this Arduino simulator, you know, it gives sometimes a simulation error. To avoid that, what I will do, I will use a DC supply of 5 volt here. I will ground this pin and 2 will be connected to analog channel A0. So let's connect analog 2 to analog channel A0 like this. In order to get a DC supply here, click on this generated mode symbol, you will get a DC as the first option. Select that and have it here. In same fashion, go to the terminal mode, take a ground and have the ground here. So now connect pin number 3 to the ground, pin number 1 to be connected to this. Regarding connections of this, you need to see my earlier video where the LM35 is interfaced with Arduino Uno. So let me increase the temperature. I am going to make this temperature say 50 degrees centigrade. fine. 50 degree centigrade is there. So now these connections are done. Save our design on the Arduino IDE, right? So here we are going to write the code. As we are using the LCD, we need to have the library for LCD. So very first command is hash include in triangle brackets. We are going to have the liquid crystal dot h. LNCR capital. Okay, now to create one object of data type liquid crystal. So I'm going to paste liquid crystal. That the object will be LCD in bracket. I'm going to write the pins that we use on Arduino, that is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes. So these are those pins. Total 6 pins are connected. Okay. Now here we are going to initialize the LCD. So I'm going to initialize the LCD as LCD dot begin in bracket 16, 2. So it is going to tell Arduino, you know, that we are using the LCD which is having 16 columns and 2 rows. Okay. Now I'm going to use a command LCD dot set cursor. Okay. Sorry, this S is small, only C is capital. LCD dot set cursor in bracket. I'm going to use 0, 0. So very first row and very first column will be used to print the character. So I'm going to print here that LCD dot print in bracket double quote temperature is space double quotes bracket close and semicolon. Let me save this file first. I did not save it. The name of the file is LM35LCD, the same name I'm using here. Okay, now this is done. And remember, as the LCD is connected in same fashion, we are using the temperature sensor LM35. So I need to have, I'm going to use hash define LM35A0 because I'm going to connect that LM35 output pin to the IDC channel A0. No semicolon here. Remember, whenever you use hash define, you do not have the semicolon at the end. But if you want to use integer, a global variable declaration, it must be terminated with the semicolon. So this is done. Now what do I want to do that? In order to get data from LM35, we require one variable. Let's have the global variable. I'm using the global variable as a say float. Okay, and that variable is say RCV, and I'm going to initialize initially it to 0.0. In same fashion, I need to convert that into temperature. So I will be using another variable temp, and its initial value is 0.0. Correct? Okay, further. Let's save this code up to this step. Now here, as you are going to get a data from that analog channel, so that is to be saved into the variable RCV. As it is analog channel, you are reading the data from analog channel from the sensor. So we are going to use the command analog read, okay, in bracket A0 instead of A0, as we defined that as LM35. I will write here LM35. So we are reading LM35 and the value will be stored in RCV. Now here, whatever the data is going to come, that data is needed to be converted. I'm going to take this RCV value, and this RCV value will be multiplied by the resolution of the ADC. As the reference voltage is 5 volt and the ADC channel is of 10 bit, total 2 to the power 10, that is 1024 steps will be there. So that will become 1024.0. Then as this is in millivolts, I need to make it in volts by multiplying by 1000, right? Now what happens is that for per degree centigrade, this sensor is going to change its value by 100 millivolt. So I need to divide this by 100. So now this value comes to be in degree centigrade. This is millivolt to degree centigrade conversion. So this will be an assignment to do this calculation in detail. How do you get this? You need to find it. Okay, that will be the assignment. Please note it down. assignment to convert the reading of RCV 10-bit reading into the degree centigrade value from millivolt to degree centigrade conversion. To print this temperature on LCD, okay, but on the next line. So what I'm going to do that, I'm going to copy these two lines and going to paste here. I'm going to write here LCD dot set cursor. Now I want to have this cursor on the next row. So zeroth column and second row. Remember, this index is for the column and this is for the row. So I have selected the next line and very first column that is having index 0, and the 1 means the second row which is having index 1. So here I'm going to print the value of the temperature. TEMP, temperature. We want to see this code first. What I want to teach you, how to write the custom characters on LCD. Okay, once this is done, and suppose that we also want to have some symbol, okay, degree centigrade symbol. And as right now we don't have any degree symbol on keyboard, so I will teach you how to get that degree symbol as a custom character creation. But meanwhile, as we will assume that we don't have that, instead of that, we'll use a star and capital C. We'll use a star and capital C. Let's do that. Okay. Fine. And let's have some delay. I will have a delay of 300. Save this code. Okay. Now what I said earlier, click on file, click on preferences. Check that this compilation and upload both are selected. Say okay, then compile this code. After compiling the code, wait for done compiling. As the done compiling message came, like this you can have this compilation details. It is possible to view all the details by changing the height of this panel or this plane. So just increase the height of this plane and look for the line which has .x file, location of .x file. So you need to come here and search for this. Yeah, I got it. It is here. So select this line. Don't select double quote symbol. And use Ctrl C to copy it. Go back to here, Arduino. Double click on Arduino. You will see the program file location. Ctrl V here. Give the path here and select OK. Okay. Once again, save and click on the run simulation. Let's see what happens. Okay, so we got the answer. The answer is temperature is 49.95 degree centigrade. Now I want to replace this star with a degree symbol. Okay, and for that you need to identify at which column it is to be written over there. So see here, this is a zeroth column, second, this is first row, this is second row. So first character is printed on zero column, next on the first column, dot is printed on, that is what decimal point is printed on the second column, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I want to have this special character at the location that is 5, 1. So location of this special character will be 5, 1. Remember this, I want to have this location over there. So we are going to set cursor to this location. So our cursor will be taken to that part, right? And we will be seeing the next code. We need to modify that. So let's stop the simulation. See, we got some message here. Again, the power supply issue is there. Okay, let's neglect that message. We want to create a special character. In order to create a special character, we require one data type, and that is nothing but a byte. Okay, byte. And suppose I want to print a symbol that is degree, and I need to have the array. Now the size of the array will be the 8 characters. Now why these 8 characters are there, let me explain this to you. Okay, just a moment. So what I want to say is that this is a LCD, and in LCD we have this as a first row and this as a second row. In each row we are having the 16 columns. Okay, so you can say that this is one box. This box, if you zoom, okay, and you will find that this box is made up of these some smaller dots. Here it is not visible, but actually if you see the LCD, and it is clearly visible over there. So there you are going to have in total, it is having total eight rows over there, and five columns are there. So here in each row, it will be having five columns. So this will be in terms of, if you want to say row comma row cross column, it will be 8,5 matrix, or if you want to say column comma row, that will be 5x8 matrix. So in short, it is having total 8 row and 5 columns. So what we want to have this degree which will have total 8 rows. So here we are going to give total 8 values, and each value will be having the 5 characters that is to be printed on your 5 columns. Okay, each column is having total 5 blocks, and each row is having 5 blocks column wise. So that we require here. So we are creating one variable that is degree, which is having total 8 locations, and its data type is byte. So what I want here is that in curly bracket, I want B, then 00110. I will explain why it is written like this. Then B, 01001, comma B, again 0. Again 1001, comma B 00110, comma B 00000 5 times, and I need to copy these 3 more times because there are 8 columns, 1 2 3 4 5. I require to have this 3 times, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. One more time. Yeah, now just close this curly bracket and semicolon. See here, each value is having total 5 binary characters. Okay, and why I'm using this, you have, this is your assignment. Why only these values are used? 00110, then 01001. In order to solve this, what I will suggest, take one paper. On that paper, draw a matrix or draw one rectangle, and that rectangle have the 8 rows and 5 columns. So you will get a matrix of 8 by 5. Each block you will have the total 8 rows and 5, total 40 blocks will be there. Then you give the numbers to the column, that is 1 2 3 4 5, and to the rows 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Then in first row, whenever you find 11 in that box, write 00110. In second row, you write 0110 and see what character get created. So like this, you can have your own custom character. They use the command lcd.createchar, any random number. You can have any random number here, comma, the variable that you are using to print the custom character, that is degree dig here. So next, remember what was the location of your special character. So let me show you. If you go over there, you can see here, the location for special character is this block. We want to have the special character in this block. So this is 0 1 2 3 4 0 1 2 3 4 and 5. This is fifth column, and the row index is 1. So this is 5,1. So it will look something like this. This is the character. Okay, this is a custom character we want to create at the location 5,1. So I need to set a cursor over there. So here I am going to write lcd set cursor. Let me copy this command, and I am going to have that in the setup only. So lcd dot set cursor. Okay, and here I will be writing 5,1. So at this location I want to print my character. Okay, and that character is handled by the random number 3. So you are going to write lcd dot, now new command, that is write, and the handler for this is the random character, that is nothing but the 3. Okay, So I'm going to write in bracket, that is data type byte, and that random character that we used, that is 3. Okay, fine. Okay, one thing is needed to be done. This C is to be taken care to be printed into next to this custom character location. So custom character location. So let me have comment here as a custom character location. So next to that, I want to print the C. So what I will do, I will again use a command, that is lcd.setCursor, and this time it will be 6,1. So on 6,1, I want to print only C. Okay, now save this and compile it. After compiling, look for the file which is having .hex location. .hex extension, sorry. So I copied the path, Control C. Let's go to your Proteus, then double click on it and give the path, select it, Control V, say OK, save and run. You can see the custom character is now created. Let me zoom and adjust the rectangle here. Again, zoom it and see, this is the custom character that we created. So this is what the tutorial is there, and I want you to create some animated characters, okay, like this. Do the task and have at least a message, or print at least 4 or 5 animated characters on first row and second row, and any random character that you want. That will be your tutorial, okay? So I think this much is there for this tutorial, and let's stop here. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.